Hey there, viewers. We've all heard how important breakfast is for you, but what if you don't want it? You might wake up feeling full, and force-feeding yourself with breakfast would be a pain. Not feeling hungry in the morning may be related to health issues. In today's video, we'll be discussing 6 reasons why you aren't hungry in the morning. Is it temporary? Is it worse than I thought? What can I do to fix it? We're talking about all that and more. Reason 1, late-night dinner or midnight snacking. We all love fancy late-night meals. Our family get-togethers and social gatherings just aren't complete without massive dinners. Enjoying a big dinner before bed could be the reason you're feeling full the next morning. Scarfing down snacks and desserts while on a Netflix binge will also curb your hunger in the morning. It has been scientifically proven that foods rich in fats and proteins keep you full for a longer time. The time required by these food groups to leave your stomach is much more than carbs. Therefore, a dinner full of protein and sugary desserts will ruin your hunger in the mornings. In these cases, it's all right to skip breakfast, but make sure you keep yourself hydrated by gulping down at least a glass of water after you wake up. What do you generally have for dinner? Are you a late-night snacker? Share your answers with the bestie community in the comment section below. Reason number 2, hormonal alteration can keep you full. The 2 major hormones that play a role in determining whether or not you're hungry are ghrelin and leptin. Ghrelin increases the appetite while leptin suppresses it. Extensive research has been carried out on these hormones. When researchers looked at ghrelin, they found its level was significantly lower in the morning than the previous night. Similarly, the results showed slightly higher levels of leptin in the morning, giving the person a feeling of fullness. Another hormone that causes the slow emptying of your stomach is adrenaline. Your adrenaline is highest in the morning, according to the studies. In these scenarios, the body starts utilizing stored carbohydrates from the liver, or breaks down muscle mass to keep your body running. There's nothing abnormal about hormones fluctuating on a daily basis. You just need to keep an eye on sharp, sudden changes. If you encounter these, seek help as soon as you can from a healthcare provider. Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all our great bestie content. Reason number 3, your emotions can take over your appetite. I'm sure everyone will agree to the fact that your mood has a direct effect on your daily activities. If you're anxious or depressed, you may have to fight with allied symptoms like fatigue and depression. This condition can have a 2-way ending. Hormones treat every individual differently. It's a personal choice which way an individual chooses. Some might start overeating and end up with eating disorders and obesity related to numerous health issues. Others may just give up on food, even after having a plate full of their favorite breakfast items in front of them. You have to keep your mental health as a top priority. Try to pull yourself out of depression with the help of family and friends. If not, try and talk to a professional. Reason number 4, pregnancy. While pregnancy can be an exciting time, it's also a bumpy ride. Around 80% of expecting mothers experience morning sickness. Having nausea and vomiting as soon as you wake up can kill your hunger. But the good news is that things improve in the second trimester of pregnancy. When you're expected to eat for 2, morning sickness doesn't even allow you to eat well for 1. An extensive study showed that 34% of women eat less during early pregnancy. Also, the high levels of progesterone during pregnancy make the digestive system sluggish. The food is not pushed out of the body faster and keeps you full for a longer period. If you can't have a big breakfast in one go, you can try smaller, more frequent meals full of healthy ingredients. Do not miss out on your beauty sleep and give your body every ounce of cellular hydration by drinking water. Remove all the trigger factors for your nausea. Keeping some citrus-scented air fresheners, aromatic candles, and potpourri can help you. Keep your home well ventilated and get rid of stagnant smells. If you still experience a loss of appetite after doing these things, talk to a gynecologist. Oh, and one other thing. If you have all of the above symptoms, you might want to take a pregnancy test. Just saying. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Watch and learn about the 8 breakfast foods that will make you look younger. Reason number 5, illness. Everyone has a day where they just don't feel like themselves. It's part of the roller coaster that is life. Sometimes we get sick out of nowhere. Any changes in the weather and temperature can lead to simple infections and cause respiratory problems like cough, cold, pneumonia, fever, etc. Your smell and taste will also change. One might feel like going days on end without food, but your doctor might advise you otherwise. If you're put on certain medications, make sure you're watching your diet. Give yourself significant time to recover by getting some sleep. Have lots of water, hot soup, beverages, and crackers. This way you have a better chance of bringing your appetite back to life. These things are pretty easy to digest. You can also try cooked apples or applesauce as well as bananas. Reason number 6, the serious causes. If If you're already taking medication, it's going to affect your appetite in some way. Drugs like antibiotics are especially notorious for killing your hunger. People suffering from reduced levels of thyroid or simply hypothyroidism will generally feel less hungry throughout the day as well. Ovulation, which occurs exactly at the midpoint of the menstrual cycle, is thought to have a direct relation to your eating pattern. Expect to feel less hungry during this time. You may be good at hiding the signs of aging, like white streaks and graying hair, but you can't fool your own body. It catches up with you sooner or later. Aging can change your hormones and decrease your appetite significantly. You just won't be as hungry. Now, this is really serious. A few long-standing illnesses like cancer, HIV, liver disorders, kidney disease, and heart problems can lead to a loss of appetite. But these are diseases for another video. Make sure you talk to a professional as soon as you can. Simple changes which might help the situation. Let's get one thing straight. Not feeling hungry the moment you wake up isn't a bad thing. The hunger pang can set in once you start your day. Maybe have breakfast around that time. If you skip breakfast entirely, be double sure you sip on lots of water. Giving your body some hydration will keep all the systems working smoothly. This is why people stress on water. Your body has a daily energy requirement and will reach it any way it can. Skipping breakfast will make you more hungry around the afternoon or evening. This is the reason you find yourself binge eating only in the evening and nighttime and not early morning. We suggest you have tiny meals right from the time you wake up. Take the breakfast you're having right now and make it better. Fix yourself a fancy, colorful, and nutritious meal with your favorite foods. Visually pleasing foods can always help create a better appetite. Also, trying out new recipes in your kitchen is also really exciting. Having breakfast can protect you from things like headaches, irritability, and fatigue. Choosing the correct foods for your breakfast is extremely important. Some tasty and healthy food ingredients are also known to reduce weight. Here's a list of the 13 best breakfast foods to help you lose weight naturally, and 12 healthy foods you should eat in the morning. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about how to become healthier with your diet. Do you struggle with eating a good breakfast? Let us know in the comments below.